بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. We are going to perform an activity which is basically in the lab activity for Microsoft Access. So this is the very first question in the lab activity. The class teacher of 8th has asked Hassan, the monitor, to create a table having details of 10 students of the class. Hassan has created a table with the following fields: admission number, name, father's name, first name, last name, not father's name, name, first name, last name, tally number, means definitely the telephone number, date of birth, bus availed, yes or no, whether the students avails the bus or not. So this is the option that we are going to take in yes or no, and then bus number. So these are the fields given over here for which we have to make a table. Can you help Hassan assign data types to the fields and enter 10 records to complete this task? How we are going to make this table in MS Access? So this is the procedure that we have to understand. In this video, I am going to explain this activity, which is given on your page number 22 in your book. So first we are going to open MS Access. Access 2013 is installed on my PC. I will take blank database and I will write in the lab 1, first activity, in the lab activity 1. Where I want to save, I will save it in my documents. You can change the location by going through any other option where you want to save it. When I will click on the create button, the MS Access will be opened. So here we are going to create the table. We will click on the create menu. It will show you different options available over here, and table is the very first option that we are going to create a table. If you see over here, different options are there which are available. So what we are going to do, we are going to take one table only, in which we are going to select the field names and their data types. So what was the very first field name we have to see on the lab activity 1? Admission number. Admission number is there, so I am going to type admission number. Admission number I have taken in, you know, the data type, which is basically the data type which is called auto number. Auto number means the numbers will be created automatically, the very first. So over here new is written, it means that the student is not supposed to enter the data over here, but data will come automatically from the starting number of 1, 2, 3, 4. Then we are going to take second field, which is name. Second field is name. So I'm typing over here name. It will be definitely, the data type is that I have taken is short text. Short text I have selected. Now for the third one, I am going to select again short text. Why? Because we are going to take first name. Short text, I'm going to write F name as mentioned in the problem statement. Then again I am going to take short text. Short text is used basically when we have to take the characters which are up to normally 255 characters. Again short text, I am going to take last name. The next field given over here is tally number, and then date of birth, and then bus availed. Tally number will be number, means we are going to enter the telephone numbers. So tally number I am going to mention over here. Then afterwards the option is there, bus availed, date of birth, sorry, first date of birth is there. So I am going to take another data type, which is date and time. Whenever we are supposed to save the data which is in the form of date and time, so we will take this type of data type, which is date and time. So I am going to mention DOB, which is date of birth. Then bus availed. For bus availed, we are going to take this data type, which is basically a Boolean data type, in which you give the answer in the form of yes or no. So I am mentioning over here bus availed. So bus availed will be in the form of yes or no. Over here you will see that it will give you a checkbox. Checkbox means that checkbox will be given to you so that if you are giving the answer in yes, you will mark it. Otherwise you will not mark it that the student is availing the bus or not. So in this way we have created a table here for the given data, and the table has been created in data sheet view. This is basically the data sheet view where we have created the table. I am going to enter three records right now, but it is your assignment. You have to enter at least 10 records because the question statement is that you have to enter 10 records over here. So what I am going to do, I am not writing anything in the admission number. Why? Automatically it is written 1. I did not mention it because I had taken the data type which was auto number. You can see that auto number data type is also there. So auto number data type is there when you are not supposed to take the numbers by yourself. The access will give you the numbers. So I am going to mention some data over here. Ali, Ahmed Khan. Telephone number, I am giving some dummy telephone number right now. Date of birth, I am going to mention the date of birth, 2nd Feb, 2008. Yes, if he is taking service of bus, I mentioned yes. If it's up to you if you are going to mention it yes or no. So we mention in real life, we mention according to the student's requirement. Then I'm going to end second record, Salim. That's the telephone number, and I'm going to take 6 April 2007. What's the date? Yes. Fatma. Heather. Rizvi. Telephone number this. Date of birth. I'm going to take the date of birth 4-2008. You can mention the date if you want to mention the type of letters, just like when I mentioned April, I mentioned AR. Or if you want to take a date in the form when we mention the date, when month also here in number, so it's up to you, it doesn't matter. So in the same way, you have to enter at least 10 records for your practice. So it is the simplest way to create a table, and the table is basically, table has been created in data sheet view. This is called data sheet view. So we have created one table. When we'll click on cross button, the table will be saved. It will ask you to save the table. In this way, we are going to save table at the end because we created the table in data sheet view. So I'm going to write the name of the table student. When I'll click OK, the table will be saved. So it is basically in the lab activity one that we have performed. We will close the file. And now this is your assignment to complete it on your Microsoft Access. Thank you so much.